With us, we have Samuel and Christian from SAP, who they will be presenting on what's new in BI 4.3 SP02 Part 1. Let's welcome
the
SAP team.
Thanks a lot. So this is Samuel Polichuk talking just for now, but the really important person today is Christian Assoun, who is working in my team, because it is him who will drive you through the 4.3 SP2 features that you guys have not been able to see in live until now. So we have only 30 minutes. So first, we are going to focus on these new features, and we'll position a couple of important features you might have seen before. I have in mind the IBIS during the summer. So in order to perform this live demo, Christian is going to use a development build. It's not an official build. Keep in mind that the final delivery is end of year, so we still have time to go. We might face bugs, and if we don't face bugs, it means it's not a real demo, okay? And last thing, keep in mind that we are not marketing guys. We are not sales guys, and so please apologize for the raw speech, okay? Now, over to you, Christian.
Thank you, Samuel. Hello. Yeah, hello, this is Christian from SAP. So I'm going to present you a couple of features, and the first one I want to introduce is the support of OData in SAP BI 4.3 SP2. This release is going to, you will be get it in December this year, and in this release, we plan to support OData. So OData is a protocol used by many vendors to exchange data, naming, for example, IBM, Microsoft, and SAP. And so here in SP2, you will be able, using OData, to retrieve data from a web intelligence document, both data contained in a query or in a block. So typically, here I have my web intelligence document. You can see that I'm in design mode. In design mode, I have my queries. And in the queries, I have this command, which is copy OData web service links. I have the same command in a block. If I select a block, I right-click it, and I have copy link for OData. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to select it, and you can see it generates an URL, which is copied in my clipboard. So it means with this URL, I can retrieve data from this block. And this is what I'm going to do. So I open Excel. But it can be any vendor that supports OData. I select get data from OData feed, and I will enter the URL that has been generated by Web Intelligence. Okay. We will support basic authentication. So I will be asked to provide my, we'll support anonymous, basic, and OAuth authentication, but here I'm going to use basic authentication, connect. I will have a dialog box where I can navigate in the flow. I select load. And the data set is displayed in Excel. And to show you that it's real live data, let's say I insert a column on the right. Here I'm going to add a formula, for example, sales revenue. I don't know if it's really, sales. So I validate.
I saw the auto-completion there.
Yeah. And then when if I come back in Excel, I refresh the query and you can see that the column has been added. Okay. And here it highlights the column that has been recognized in the formula. Okay. So this is a way to reach to use this OData link generated by Web Intelligence. Another way to use it is to use it in Webby itself, because here we have been able to expose an OData flow, but Webby in 4.3 SP2 will be able to consume OData as well. So here I'm creating a new document. So you will see there's a new dialog box where you can select a couple of repositories, so BI Platform Repository, Google Drive, and Web Service. And in Web Service, you have the options to select Web Intelligence OData Web Service. So what I can do, I can use a URL from a document stored in the same repository, but it has less interest because in this case, you can create a document on top of another Web Intelligence document. What is interesting is to use this OData from another server. And you can see that here I have two servers. This first one, from which I'm going to generate the URL, copy link for OData. It's the same that I've used already. And here, another server provide this URL. And here I get the query panel. I can select the objects that I want to retrieve in the document. Click refresh to preview the data. You can see in the properties that I have the URL in the properties dialog box. Of course, I can select the objects I want to retrieve. And I, as universe, I can also use a filter to filter the data that will be retrieved. Here, I'm going to use a prompt. And when I run the query. So unfortunately, there is no list of value for the moment. So I have to type the value manually. Or I can also copy and paste them from a text file and add them in the prompt. I run the query. And here you can see the data has been retrieved in my report. And I have a list of objects in my objects side panel. Okay. What we will officially support is OData coming from Webby. We have decided to limit the scope of what we support because OData spec is very large and we were not sure we were able to support all OData. So officially we'll support only OData coming from Webby, but you can see that if I use the OData sample, which is the official sample provided by OData organization, it's working as well. Can run. I still have my prompt from my previous query. Add it in another report. And here another query coming from the sample, the OData sample, which is available. Okay. I'm going to save this document. One comment about here, I have connected to another BI4 server. To authenticate, we support basic authentication. And to allow this, you need to create what we call a data source reference. Data source reference is something, it's like the secondary business object credential. It's something we have introduced in 4.3, because in 4.2, you have only one single business objects credential. In 4.3, we have added data source reference. You have to name in OData Web Intelligence, and then you can provide the credentials for the other OData server. Here, the other BI 4.3 machine, okay? So this is for OData. What we have introduced back in 4.3 is the shared element. So shared element is something that was introduced in 4.2, is the ability to save a block in
your repository.
Yes.
One question related to what you show about OData. If you show that you take a link from a Webby document, and you put that into a third-party tool like Excel, Tableau, whatever.
Yeah.
So what if the Webby document is scheduled then?
But it's perfect because the data will be refreshed, and then the next time you open your Excel file and you refresh your your document, it will retrieve the data as long as you. Okay, I see what you mean. It's about the instance, correct?
Yeah.
The instance, I think, if you use the show last instance, it will retrieve the last data set, but it has to be confirmed. Okay. But I see what is you are talking about. You want to know if the last the schedule will replace the data set.
Yeah.
Okay. So I was talking about shared element. So shared element was introduced in 4.2. It's the ability to save in the same as repository a block. And in the block, you save everything related. In the shared element, you save everything that is needed to build this block, meaning the query, the data provider, the formatting. So this was not yet in 4.3, and so it's back in 4.3 SP2. So I'm going to take the block I've used from OData. And here I'm going to see you have now the menu shared element, save as. And so I can have a dialog box. I can select the folder when I want to save my shared element. And option and categories, but I want to save it. Okay, it's save. So now if I create another document, the data source, I can just say insert, shared element. So I can browse by folder, by the list of all shared elements in the repository or by category. But here I know is this shared element. I insert it and I put it here. Okay. And what we have added a side panel with that list all the shared elements used by the document. What I can do if I want to reuse a second time the same shared element, I can say insert. I add again my shared element. Let's say a third time, insert again. And what is new in 4.3 SP2 is here you have the list of all places where this shared element is used. So if I click here, I switch to a first report where the shared element is located. Okay, if I want to, and if I insert another one, for example, the SAP logo, insert. So it's listed in the side panel as well. Okay. And if I click on the query, you will see the query that came with the shared element. Okay. Another nice feature in 4.3 SP2 is the geodimension in universe. So it's only for universe created with information design tool. In 4.2, you have the ability to define a geodimension in the web intelligence document. However, if you have many web intelligence documents, you have to do it each time for each document. Now, what you can do in 4.3 SP2 in your universe, so here I'm information design tool, I have city, and here I have a tab named geomapping where I can select the detail that will be used for latitude and longitude, and the one that will be used for longitude. Okay, so when I have set these two details for the geomapping, the dimension will become a geodimension. And then when I go back to Web Intelligence, if I let's return to this document. If I add a new query, add query, so I select universe. So first you will see we have a new dialog box to browse into the universe. So you can have the list of universe as in 4.2, but you can also browse by folders. Okay, and you have different icons to differentiate the classic universe created with universe design tool and the one created with information design tool. So I will select my universe containing the geodimension. here it is. In the query panel, unfortunately, there's still no the icon for geodimension. So this will, it's a known bug. I hope it will be resolved quickly. Okay. I run the query. So I still have my prompt from my previous OData query. Okay. And here in my list of objects, you can see that city came as a geodimension. So it means if I turn this table as a geo chart, for example, geobubble, it will automatically be displayed in the map. Okay, knowing in the universe, the two latitude and longitude details bring back the latitude and longitude of the cities. Okay. Next topic, you may have seen that in the list of data source, we have Google Drive. So what does it mean? It means we have the ability to, if you have some Google spreadsheet or Excel file or text file that you have shared on the Google Drive, you can use them as a data source for web intelligence. You need to ask your administrator to do some configurations to connect BI403 to Google Drive using OAuth authentication. But once it's done, so I can, here I'm going to say, let's go on the Google Sheet. I say Google Sheet. For the moment, this UI is the Google UI. Okay, so it is as it is. But we intend to replace it by another UI that we will write ourselves. Why? Because in a short term, we expect to support as well Microsoft OneDrive and Microsoft SharePoint as a file repository. And once we are, and when we are going to support it, we are going to rewrite a nice UI to browse both in Google Drive and in Microsoft. So I'm going to unselect this Google spreadsheet. It's like an Excel, but it's a Google. So I can define my which spreadsheet I want to which sheet I want to use, the range definition and so on. I click OK. And here I get the objects, the columns of my spreadsheet. I can select the one I want to use my report. I can add some filters. So let's say we select a prompt, it's city. And because we have two prompts on city, they will be merged, and the same prompt will be used both for the OData query and this Google spreadsheet query. I run it, and that I get in my document the data coming from the Google spreadsheet. Okay, and so you can see in my list of objects, you have all the queries from OData, the universe, and the Google. You have a new icon from the Google spreadsheet. But it's the same way if it's a text and an Excel file stored on Google Drive. Talking about Excel and TXT, you may have seen that till now, each time I was doing a query, I've used the same query panel than the one for Universe. Okay? And the idea indeed in 403 SP2 was to use this query panel for all data sources. And this includes as well Excel and text files. So here I'm selecting Excel as a data source. Let's say this one. And here it will differ from what you know, because in 402, when you select an Excel file, you have to take all the columns. And if you have an Excel file containing 50 columns, you have to retrieve all these columns. Here, using the same universe, the same query panel used for universe, you can select the objects you want to query. You can also add some filters. So let's say this one, I will say greater than être une habitante. OK. Refresh. OK. Run. OK. I still have my prompts. And I have my objects from the Excel file here. As we have used the Universe Query Panel, so we have been able to select the objects to add filters, but we have not been able to change the name or set the object qualification or object data type. And this is now done in a second step. After you have run the query, we have introduced a panel here in the, which is named Properties. And in this properties panel, when you select the objects, you have all the properties of the object that you can change. Okay, so here I'm going to name city as my city. I want to select latitude as a detail of my city. Apply. Longitude has also a detail of my city, apply. So I can do whatever I want as I used to do previously in the Excel query panel. Okay, so now it's done in this property. But as we have introduced this properties site panel, we have also taken the opportunity to also allow you to modify the objects coming from any data source, not only Excel or text file. Meaning if you have, for example, here a universe, objects coming from a query from universe, I can change the name of the object, rename, add a description. Okay. Because I have changed the objects coming from the universe itself, the universe has its own semantic, and somehow we have overwritten the semantic coming from the universe. And so I have a little icon here to tell me, oh, by the way, you see, you have changed, remember, you have changed what is coming from the universe. Okay. So I've been able to change the name and description. I can, and more important, for them, for a measure, I can change the aggregation. For example, if you have a measure coming from universe, a SAP HANA or SAP BW data source, and you don't like the way they are aggregated in these data systems, instead of going back to the IT guy who is responsible for the SAP BW or SAP HANA, you can directly change the aggregation here. For example, merging, I want to, instead of sum, I want to say, okay, select max. Okay, and now, the aggregation of margin will be full max. Okay. So here I still have a little icon to say that I've changed the properties coming from the universe. If I want to revert back the initial properties, I can ever click the icon here. Okay. I switch back to the initial value or just click revert here to revert all the properties from the objects, and I click apply. Okay, and as I'm running out of time, very quickly, I'm going to show you how we have used as well these properties for the variables. Oh, sorry. Yes, let's do it. So first thing, we have introduced a new format editor. So the previous format editor was a little, you didn't have many space to write your formula. So now we have rewritten it. We added many new nice features in this formula editor, like coloring. We are able to do syntax analysis. You have completion. Okay. We manage the parentheses. So if you can see, you have and so on and so on. And we have a list of lines. I don't know if this, no, I don't think it's valid. So let's say, okay, measure. Okay, will it work? Yes, okay. So I have created my variable. And here in these properties, site panel, I have also the ability to very quickly change the properties of my variable. Okay, if I want to change the formula, I don't have to open the formula editor. I can just modify it on the fly, either the name, the formula, or the qualification, or whatever. Okay, do I still have some time, or is it, am I done?
There's a question for you.
Okay, go ahead.
Well, there's a question, and you were presenting, you know, several queries coming from Google Sheet or Excel and the universe, and the question was, if you've got some prompts which are, you know, the same, where does the list of value come from? I guess from the universe, but I'm not sure.
Ah, indeed, that's an interesting question. I don't know. I know they are merged. We need to check. I need to check because I didn't test it, so to be honest. Here in what I've shown, they have been shared because City was... Okay. For universe, do we have a universe? Let's check if you have City here.
Oh, yes.
Prompt. Now, run. I don't know if we are going to... Okay.
Yeah. But we might have some more cities in all the other, you know, Excel file, Google Sheet, or whatever.
No, because for a moment, we don't... We are not able to retrieve a list of values from Excel and text. It's only from BW and universe.
Okay.
But we expect to provide also the list of value for... that's why I had to type them manually. But hopefully we'll be able to retrieve them from Excel and text file. And in case the prompt are merged, I assume we'll try to do the union of both the list of values.
Okay. Paul?
Yes, there's been quite a lot of questions coming in, and I see, Sam, you've been busy away trying to answer them as quickly as possible. If we don't answer them during the next couple of minutes, we will answer them in the next 10 to 15 minutes. So just bear with us and you will get your answers coming through. But thank you so much, Christian. That was absolutely fascinating. A lot of interesting new stuff there around the OData piece, which I think a lot of people are going to be interested in, you know, as well as obviously, you know, using data sources now, you know, with Semantic Layer and being able to pull them from all different places, and now Google Drive as well. I think that's going to really open up some interesting options for a lot of Business Objects customers. So that was awesome, and we're definitely looking forward to part two next month as well. So if you don't mind both staying on in the Q&A chat session to get through the rest of the typed in questions, that would be great. And I'll hand it back to Lucy now to introduce the next presenter. Thank you again.